I'm Isaac Zabi, Publications Manager at Strategic Treasurer, and I'm here with Craig Jeffrey, Founder and Managing Partner of Strategic Treasurer, to discuss one of our most recent publications, the 2017 Supply Chain Finance Analyst Report. So to start, Craig, this being the first Supply Chain Finance report released by Strategic Treasurer, tell us a bit about what prompted your team to create this report and also touch on some of the key elements contained within it.
So supply chain financing has been a topic that organizations have been dabbling in over the past decade or so, and it's been increasingly important. And because of its growth, first in the banking sector with bank products, and now oversized growth with fintech companies, it's become more and more important. And a definition and a review of the space was very important. And so we decided to add this to our Treasury Analyst Report series. And so, it's a perfect time to cover this in depth. So what topics do we cover in this? We cover a number of things. So we outline the business case for supply chain finance. So we look at not just the finance and the capital sectors, but we look at efficiency and taking a holistic view as opposed to just finance or just procurement. We look at both items there and provide information there. We also give an overview of how supply chain finance technology has evolved and changed over the past several years. There's been a lot of developments, primarily through the fintech sector, which are influencing the banking sector. Third, we give an explanation of some of the different types of supply chain financing approaches, everything from reverse factoring to some of the tools that support different models like dynamic discounting. We look at an analysis of the benefits and challenges of modern day supply chain finance, because they're different than before. And we provide some quite in-depth coverage of some of the leading suppliers of supply chain finance, including SAP Ariba, Taulia, and Kariba.
Great. So you mentioned an outline of the business case as being one of the key components. Could you elaborate a bit on what the key drivers are within the industry currently that are driving increased adoption of these solutions?
Sure. So a couple things that drive people to supply chain finance. You think about supply chain and finance. They can be thought about separately, but when you put those together, it's looking at the entire process. How do I fund my supply chain? How do I finance that? There's a relationship with a supplier, a relationship with a customer. Your payables impacts my receivables. So a couple of things that have impacted that. One is the globalization of companies. Companies are dealing in more countries, in more currencies than ever before. This creates a challenge on the supply chain finance side. That's one key element. Second is, people are starting to say, how can I optimize the entire process, not just optimize components? And as Anonymous and some other people are attributed to the saying, optimizing part of the process sub-optimizes the whole. And so why people are looking at this now and looking at it in a collaborative environment, treasury, supply chain, payables, et cetera, they're looking at it because they need access to capital, or they want to provide access to capital without breaking the relationships, and are looking at the overall process of ordering, paying, and self-serving. So this is driving a lot of the activity towards supply chain financing. It lends itself to the democratization of capital. You can get capital from your banks through multiple providers and through your supply chain without breaking your other partners.
So along those lines, you mentioned that one of the interesting features of this report is that supply chain finance is discussed primarily from a fintech standpoint as opposed to a bank view. Could you elaborate a little bit on why you took this approach and why fintech solutions are causing such a disruption within the industry?
Sure. So you think about the strengths of banks. Banks are not necessarily known as innovators in technology. They're usually providing great services, but they're great with their balance sheets. They have access to a tremendous amount of capital. They have a risk management framework. They provide access to liquidity to organizations all over the place. So they've been very strong in that historically. Now, fintech firms aren't necessarily balance sheet oriented, but they're very much process oriented, leveraging technology. So the reason we're focused on this is much of the change and the oversized portion of growth in the supply chain financing sector is coming through the fintech firms. And the reason it's coming through the fintech firms is they're developing technology to offer more models, additional flexibility, expanded networks that allow people to connect to more of their suppliers very quickly. So it's a broader view and perspective. And in fact, banks are adopting many of these types of capabilities and trying to bring those into the fold. So the focus was on where the most change is coming on, and that's why we focused on fintech.
So in terms of sort of an outlook for growth, what do you expect to see from supply chain finance in the coming years, and also along those lines from fintech solutions in general moving forward?
Well, we are looking at doing another one of our surveys to help determine market size and projections in that space. But we've seen pretty substantial growth, particularly in the fintech area of supply chain finance, in the double digits year over year. From 2010 to 2015, there's some information from McKinsey which shows the growth has exceeded 15% in each of those years. They look to see it continuing at 10%. We expect it to continue to grow at double-digit rates for the foreseeable future, for the next 4 or 5 years at least. There's quite a bit of capacity. There's a lot of runway left to expand. And that's a positive thing, not only for the fintech providers, but also for the bank providers, but primarily for everyone involved in, you know, buying or selling. Having that extra flexibility is vitally important.
In addition to providing a broad overview of the supply chain finance landscape, another feature of the report is that we discuss individual providers of SCF technology in detail. Could you talk a bit about what providers are highlighted within the report and what the scope of coverage is for them?
So I'll just talk about the three providers first. So Kariba, many of you know who are listening will think of their treasury management system. Well, this is integrated into that platform. They have a software as a service or SaaS platform that provides this functionality. They've been doing this for about 17 years. They introduced a supply chain finance modular component into their product suite back about 7 years ago in 2010. So Kariba has a customer base of more than 1,500 clients, and they're leveraging that through their customer base as well as other sales that could just be related to supply chain finance. We also look at SAP Ariba. Maybe people knew Ariba before SAP had acquired them. So they got their start in the procurement space back in 1996, so a little over 20 years ago. But they've expanded their functionality in their cloud-based solution and expanded their network. So they have a full suite of financial supply chain solutions covering pretty much every aspect of the process, from procurement to payment and the flip side for the other party. Talya is also a global provider of supply chain finance solutions. They have about a decade of experience in the industry. They have greater than 1.3 million companies on its network, and they're in over 160 countries. There's not, there's about 200 countries in the world, depending on how you count those, so they have great coverage. These three companies really represent a majority of the new sales in the supply chain finance landscape. And I think everyone would consider these three of the leading providers in the space generally, not just among fintech. So you asked about coverage. What does it include? So we give a summary overview of the company. We cover recent headlines, awards they've received, just so you can see what the media is looking at, so the readers can gain that information. We do an in-depth product review, looking at what the product capabilities are, how it's offered, and its development. We also look at the company's strengths. We review and provide a case study for each company, real-life case study. And we give information on each firm's implementation approach, their customer support structures, how are you going to get support for that, the onboarding process of you as a customer, how does that work, and then what are the client training opportunities so each company can continue to expand the value of this tool that they have at their disposal.
So for anyone interested in learning more about supply chain finance and about the vendors covered in this report, where can they find that information?
Well, for this report, you can find it on our website. If you go to strategictreasury.com, on our main page, you have access to it. And you can see on the screen a link to that, and down below in the comment section, a link that'll let you register and download the report for free.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Craig, and thank you everyone for watching.